Hi guys, it's another YouTube homework helper, and tonight we're going to talk about word problems with money. So let's get started. First, I see that Nick paid $2.26 for a sandwich and $2.15 for a drink. The question is, how much change will he receive if he pays with a $5 bill? First thing that I want to do is I want to circle important information that's going to help me when I set up this problem. I see that he paid $2.26 for a sandwich. That's important. I see that he paid $2.15 for a drink. That's also important. I'm going to need to add both of those up in order to find out what my total is for us to have to pay. Right here, I've set it up. $2.26 plus $2.15. That's the first step. 6 plus 5 is 11. Carry my 1. 2 plus 1 is 3, and 1 more is 4. Drop down your decimal point since we're talking about money. 2 plus 2 is 4. So now I know that Nick is going to need to pay $4.41 for the food and drink that he's ordering, but he's using a $5 bill. So now I have to go into step 2, which is subtracting the $4.41 from the $5 bill that he's going to pay. All right, I go all the way over to the 5. It becomes a 4. This 0 becomes a 10. Now I can cross it off and it becomes a 9, so that this becomes a 10. 10 take away 1 is 9. 9 take away 4 is 5. I drop down my decimal point. 4 plus 4 take away 4 is 0. I don't need to put a 0 there. I can just put my dollar sign. And now I know that what he is going to receive is going to be 59 cents. That's his total that he's going to get back. All right, let's go to the next slide. Here's another problem. Gabby gave Cody $1.48. If Gabby had started with $3, how much does he have left? The first thing I want to do is look for important information. I see that Gabby gave Cody $1.48. I also see that Gabby started with $3, and I see how much does he have left. This tells me I'm going to set up my problem as a subtraction problem. So I have to start with the $3 at the top, and then I have $1.48 that I'm going to be taking away since that's what Gabby gave to Cody. So we're going to just simply subtract. I go over to my 3, it becomes a 2, my 0 becomes a 10, my 10 becomes a 9, this 0 becomes a 10, 10 take away 8 is 2, 9 take away 4 is 5, I drop down my decimal point, 2 take away 1 is 1, drop down my dollar sign, and now I know that Gabby is going to have $1.52 left after he gave some to Cody. All right. Let's advance to the next slide because this is where you're going to get to try it out. Here's your problem. Holland spent $1.64 on a shake and $2.95 on a meal. If she gave the cashier a $5 bill, will she have enough money? Go ahead and pause the slide, try it out for yourself, and then come on back and we'll check it together. Okay, I hope that you tried it out for yourself, and let's go ahead and see if you did all the things that I'm going to do. Did you notice that Holland spent $1.64 and $2.95? So you are going to need to add that up. Let's go ahead and do that quickly. Not 4 plus 5 is 9, 6 plus 9 is 15. Drop that decimal, add your 1 at the top. 2 plus 1 is 3, and 1 more makes 4. So Holland spent $4.59, but it says that she had $5. So would she have enough money? Yes, she will. Let's find out how much change she gets back. So we're going to take that $4.59, and we're going to subtract it. We have to go over here, make this a 10. Then it becomes a 9. This becomes a 10. We have a 1. We have 4. Drop the decimal point down. And what this tells me is that yes, Holland has enough money. In fact, she has over, she has 41 cents over. All right, let's advance the slide and you're gonna try the next one on your own too. Fern has $4.67 in her bank at home. Michelle has $2.39. How much more does Fern have than Michelle? Go ahead and pause the video, look for important words, try it out, and then come on back and see me. Okay, I hope that you tried this out on your own. I hope that first of all, what you did was circle important information. The $4.67 is important. The $2.39 is important. And then we have to look at what they're actually asking. They want to know how much more than. And if you're in my class, we do this. How much more than. And we know that that means to compare. And whenever we compare, we subtract. So I'm going to go ahead and subtract these two. I have to go over here, make this a 17. This becomes 8. 5 take away 3 is 2. Drop down my decimal point. 4 take away 2 is 2. $2.28 is how much more money Fern has than Michelle. And I hope you're getting better at word problems with money. Bye now.